Covering the Capitol Watch at 6, Governor Dave Heineman today unveils his plan to balance Nebraska's budget. It's a four-part approach calling for an across-the-board cut of 2.5% of most agencies this year and a 5% cut next year. He also wants to cancel an increase in state aid for schools next year and adjust payment levels for Medicaid. He's calling for transferring $37 million from several budget lines into the general fund. And he says several state agencies have helped Nebraska save $65 million from last year's budget. Total savings, $336 million. The Appropriations Committee likes his approach.
Because most of the pain will be felt more in the second year, I would have to agree with the, you know, maybe the job cuts won't be there. I'm not saying down the road that, I mean, these agencies are going to have to deal with these cuts as they see fit.
So the agencies now, the public, the citizens of Nebraska, have a starting point, and I think it's a good starting point. But there's going to be a lot more detail that has to be dug into.
The Appropriations Committee will go over the governor's plan in preparation for the special session, which begins Wednesday. Now, to bring you more complete coverage on the governor's proposal, Governor Heineman joins us live from the state capitol in Lincoln. Governor, thanks for joining us this evening.
Good evening, Rob.
You bet. First, no tax increase, no jobs or services lost. How do you do that?
Well, you work very, very hard. We worked with state agencies. For example, last year we implemented a new policy. Instead of at the end of the fiscal year, it's always spend it or lose it. We went to save it and keep it. And state agencies saved us $65 million. We also worked with the education community. I've been in contact with superintendents, school boards, and others, and they said we want to be part of the solution, but in order to do that, make any adjustments in the second fiscal year. That's exactly what we're doing. We're trying to work with everyone. We've got a plan that reduces spending, no tax increase.
But Governor, I do have to ask you, the state has a substantial reserve, $300-some million. You want to use about $250 million of it. Why not use more? Why not save jobs now?
Rob, that's a very good question. The key is we're already using $250 million. If you look in the out biennium, the deficit is expected to be $568 million. We'll need that additional cash reserve for the challenges in 2 years.
Sure, but those are likely losses. There's a chance, I would imagine, even though possibly small, that those losses may not happen. So I guess the question is, save the jobs now when you may, instead of losing jobs, it may be gone later.
Well, Rob, I want to make one additional point. In that out biennium, it's projected a very rosy economic forecast that I don't think is going to happen. So our budget challenge is even greater. But we're trying to preserve all the jobs we can right now. The way in which we've done this, very detailed, very specific, and very responsibly, I think by and large you won't see any major job losses, at least in the current fiscal year.
Well, finally, Governor, I want to ask you, you mentioned if not job losses, no services cut either. You've gone over the budget. Which services in your mind could be eliminated or could be cut next year?
Well, hopefully none of that will happen. We've tried to do it in an across-the-board manner or very specific reductions that reflect the appropriate needs of each state agency. But again, the key, if you do it carefully, we can do it in areas where we don't affect services, we don't affect eligibility. That's what we're trying to do.
Okay. Governor Heineman, thank you for joining us live tonight, and hopefully we'll continue our conversation live again here at 10 o'clock.
Thank you, Rob.